Hello students, let's begin the topic question answer discussion of class 10 chapter control and coordination from page number 125. The first question is how does chemical coordination takes place in animals? So chemical coordination takes place in animals with the help of chemical messenger that is called hormones. And hormones are the chemical fluid, chemical substances that are secreted by specific glands that is endocrine glands, and hormone regulate growth, development and homeostasis of the animals. Why is use to iodized salt? Why is the use of iodized salt advisable? Use of iodized salt is advisable to avoid the deficiency of iodine. If the intake of iodine is low, the release of thyroxine. Actually, thyroxine is iodine containing hormone. So from the thyroid gland will decrease. That affects the carbohydrate, protein, and fat metabolism. Thyroxine is an iodine containing hormone. Okay. So thus a person may have goiter problem in case if intake of iodine is lowered. The next question is, how does our body respond when adrenaline is secreted in the blood? You know that adrenaline is an emergency hormone. So, and adrenaline is secreted in large amount when a person is frightened or mentally disturbed. When it reaches the heart, it beats faster by supplying more oxygen to our muscles. The breathing rate also increases because of the contraction of diaphragm and ribs muscles. It also raises the blood pressure and allow more glucose to enter in the blood. All these responses together enable our body to deal with the emergency. So adrenaline is a hormone secreted when a person is frightened or mentally disturbed. Clear? So adrenaline increases the heartbeat rate, blood supply in the muscles. Okay, it also increases the breathing rate. So it is an emergency hormone. It helps to cope with the body from any emergency condition. Question number 4, why are the some patients of diabetes treated by giving injection of insulin? Okay, diabetes is a disease which is caused by the deficiency of insulin. Okay, and you know that Insulin regulate the blood glucose level. That is, extra glucose is converted into the glycogen in the liver. And insulin is a protein. If we take insulin by mouth in the form of tablet, it can be digested. So that's why in order to maintain the blood glucose level, insulin is taken by the injection. From page number 26, which of the following is a plant hormone? Cytokinin. Okay. The gap between two neurons is called the synapse. The brain is responsible for thinking, reasoning, all of the things. Regulating the heartbeat, balancing the body. Okay. So what the function of receptors in our body? Think of situation where receptors do not work properly, when problems are likely to arise. Receptors are present throughout the body, mainly in sense organs. So receptors collect the information about the changes, what happened around us. So and send the signal information to the brain, which render effect mechanism against the changes. So when receptor do not work properly, the environmental stimuli are not able to create nerve impulses and the body does not respond. The question is to draw the structure of neuron and explain its function. So you know that this is the structure of neuron. This is the nucleus. This is the dendrites. This is the cell body, cyton. Cell body is also called cyton. This is the axon, and these are the axon terminal and nerve ending. So this is the swan cell, and the gap between two swan cells is called the node of Ranvier. So this is the structure of neuron. You know that the function of neuron is to transmit nerve impulses. So here dendrite detect information and send it to the cell body. Cell body maintain growth of the cell. Axon conduct message away from the cell body and signal to the next neuron. Next question, what does phototropism occur? How does phototropism occur? It is directional movement. Directional movement and growth of plant in response to light is called the phototropism. Phototropism occurs due to increased auxin on the dark side or shady side and decreased auxin on the illuminated side. So because of presence of more auxin, leaf in darker side grows faster, causing it a bend towards source of light. Actually, when any plant detect light, they form auxin on their tip. And auxin always transported to from the towards the shady sides. So the function of auxin to stimulate the cell grow longer. So if the shady side cells is grow longer, the plant part bend towards the light. Which signals will disrupted in case of a spinal cord injury? In case of a spinal cord injury, reflex action impulses from various parts will not to be conducted to brain. So message from brain will not be conducted to various organs of the body. How does chemical coordination occur in plants? So plant growth, development and response to the environment is controlled and coordinated by a special class of chemical substances that are called the plant hormones. Hormones are produced in a part of the plant and are transported to all needy part of plants. So five major types of phytohormone, that is auxin, gibberellins, cytokinins, abscisic acid and ethylenes. So these phytohormones are either growth promoter, that is auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin, these are the growth promoter, and growth inhibitor is abscisic acid. So next question, what is the need for a system to control and coordinate in an organism? So there are various organs in an organism, and these organs must be carefully controlled and coordinated for the survival of an organism. So in the body of an organism, various fluids are secreted from glands of the endocrine system. So these hormones are responsible for the overall growth development of an organism. Overall growth development of an organism. So all other daily decisions that are include voluntary and involuntary are controlled by the central nervous system, that is CNS. So coordination is need for all living activities we perform. So our nervous system receive information from surrounding, which is proceed and respond in elicited. So the endocrine system help in integrating various metabolic activities like reproduction, development and all reflex action and cope with the various situations. So hormonal system in the plant, in the process of photosynthesis, they need carbon dioxide, water and sunlight. So stomatal opening in the leaves open up in to allow the carbon dioxide, root bends toward water, the stem towards the lice. So tendril is climbing part are supported by the hormonal system of the plant body. So thus we need to control and coordinate system in an organism. How are the involuntary action and reflex action are different from each other? So it is involuntary, the rapid response to the stimulus without the conscious involvement, without the involvement of brain of the involvement of the brain. While involuntary occurs with the consciousness of an organism. Reflex action is controlled by spinal cord here. Involuntary action is controlled by the medulla oblongata, that is the part of hindbrain, or sometimes it is controlled by the midbrain. It is very quick and spontaneous, while it is relatively slower involuntary action. It is a reflex action may involve any muscles or gland, and here involuntary action involve only smooth muscles. Next, in reflex action can be conditioned. It cannot be influenced by external condition. For example, reflex action like blinking of eyes and salivation. An involuntary action is the beating of heart and blood circulation. Next question is compare and contrast nervous and hormonal mechanism for the control and coordination animal. So nervous control, it consists of nerve impulses between PNS, CNS and brain. And hormonal control, it consists of endocrine system which secrete hormone directly into the blood. Nervous system response time is very fast, short, while hormonal system response is very long. Nerve impulses are not specific in their action, while hormones are very specific in their action. Nerve impulses, nervous system, the flow of information is very rapid in nervous system, while the flow of information is very slow in hormonal system. Next question is, what is the difference between manner in which movement takes place in a sensitive plant and movement in our legs? So movement in sensitive plant, the movement in sensitive plant is response to stimulus by the touch is an involuntary action, and the movement in our leg is voluntary action. Movement in sensitive plant, there is no special tissue for this. There is no special tissue for the transfer of information in the plants, while here in our legs, in our human system, CNS, PNS are the system which can transfer the information. So in plants, cells do not have a specialized protein for movement, while animal cells have specialized protein which help in the movement like muscles. So this is the question and answer of the chapter number 2, biology, control and coordination.